Hey guys, so this is another of my movie reviews. So today I'm going to be reviewing the new Superman movie, the reboot, I guess if you want to call it, Man of Steel. So it's obviously Man of Steel, 2013 American superhero film, directed by Zack Snyder. Produced by Christopher Nolan, and it's based on, obviously, Superman, duh. It's a reboot, and it's all about the origins of Superman. It stars Henry Cavill, I'm not sure, as Clark Kent / Kal-El / Superman. Amy freaking amazing gorgeous Adams as Lois Lane. Michael Shannon as the bad guy, General Zod. Diane Lane as Martha Kent. Kevin Costner as Jonathan Kent. Lawrence Fishburne as Perry White. And Russell Crowe as Jor-El. And what did I think of this movie? I loved it. I love this movie. It's a completely different version from what we've seen before of the story. A lot of the Superman films are like, yeah, he was sent from Krypton, but it doesn't explain a lot of why. This one, I'm not going to spoil it, but it's all about how the planet Krypton is all going a bit downhill. They've used up all of their planet's resources and things are not going well. So Kal-El's parents decide to send him off as a baby to Earth so that he can be the last of their kind and, you know, maybe someday do something that would create the new race of Kryptonians. So, it follows like how he lands on Earth and then Jonathan Kent and Martha Kent find him. They take him in as their own. They raise him. They know something's up because he's got these really strong powers and he's like just insanely strong. He saves his classmates in one scene. That's not too much of a spoiler because it's in the trailers. Yes. So it's all about him and it has like flashbacks and things showing different things he's done. And the movie is basically about Clark / Kal-El / Superman. And it's about General Zod. Now General Zod is this guy from Krypton who had staged a coup against the like High Council of Krypton and he was trying to destroy them because he didn't like how they were doing things. So he was really, really angry that they had sent Clark off to Earth and he'd been punished and he'd been sent off to this place. It's some kind of like black holy type thing where him and his crew were sent off in like, I suppose it's some kind of like purgatory. However, when certain things happen, which I won't spoil, they get out. They spend about 30 something years searching for Kal-El and then they finally find him on Earth living a secret existence. And it's, the movie's all about how Zod wants to basically kill him. And it's all about the fact that he decides that if he can't have Krypton, then he will make Earth into new Krypton and destroy the human race. Not a good thing. As always, I'm not going to go into too many details because I don't want to spoil it. This film was badass. I thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed this film. The one thing I would say is there are some scenes, some fight scenes and the action scenes. They did go on a tiny bit too long. It was nearly half of the movie was fight scenes, which was good, but you know, they could have switched things up a bit and done different things, but it was good. It was a great movie. I would definitely recommend it. I went to see it in 2D because I don't do 3D and I really enjoyed it. So, as for my rating, after thinking about a couple of things, I was going to originally give this a 10 out of 10. I'm actually going to give it a 9.5 out of 10 because it was great, but the action scenes did go on a little bit too long and it did drag a little bit. It is like a 2.5 hour movie and I think like 45 minutes is action scenes. Yeah. So, have you seen Man of Steel? Do you want to see Man of Steel? You should go and see Man of Steel. If you have seen it, leave a comment down below and let me know what you thought. If you haven't seen it, leave a comment down below and let me know why you want to see it. So that's my little movie review for Man of Steel. Hope you enjoyed it. And I will see you soon. Bye guys.